Thank you, Professor Lin. This was brought in a program. These are the questions the community asked us. Probably Bill Green and the group could have answered some, but we also thought we needed to share with you, especially as policymakers and technical wing at the district level, to know the kind of the questions that are coming. Because as you go through sensitize the community, these are the same things that may come up. So probably we wanted, some of them we have already discussed them in the discussion we have just had, but others probably would have a few of more understanding and the context behind some of these questions. And about resettlement management, the issue of compensation, I think we've talked about it. But now, what we did not also talk about it is about, usually they compensate, I don't know the terms of the compensation, but they also, the community would want, if I lost my cows during a landslide, would I be compensated? Those are some of the questions they would want to know during relocation and resettlement. These are some of the questions. Then the other issue is about the guarantee of the land. This is also okay. This came up, we discussed this in the morning. If I live with a ranger, who will own that land? Or if I live with Duda, who will own that land? Is it government that's to remain my land, or it remains the land of the what? Of the government. Those are some other questions you also need to ask yourself as you do sensitizations, because I know you are the people who will actually take lead in doing sensitization at a community level, especially during these disasters. So the community would want to know how you are taking me to the end of what will happen, but where I'm living, where this land here, who will own it? Then they also go ahead and say, if I've gone to Ulaguri, who will own that where I'm settled? Do I have any document? Because some of the issues that came were like, here, I know it was my father's land, my ancestral land. No one will come to displace me from here. But what assurance do I have, especially where I'm going? The other question was about the transportation of children, the animals, and the agricultural products. Do you always cater for this during relocation? If I have two cows in Bududa and I'm being relocated, do you also take my cows in Chiliandongo? Probably you would have more insights about it, but I don't know how it is done. But these are the questions that came up. Do you, Honorable Chairman, do you always move people with their cows in Chiliandongo?
No, you go alone.
You don't do that. So you see, people will always come back to look for their cows. So it's something you also need to think about, because those are the questions that came up. Then the other was about, I live in this village, I have my own network. So if I am resettled, do you take into consideration that if I was neighboring this person, do I remain neighboring him? And that's where even the other issue of leadership came in. Someone is saying, I'm the chairman, LC1, I control Honorable George, I control Lamoran, I control this. If I go to Chiliandongo, do I maintain that kind of power to take control of these people? Then the other person keeps on saying, I know this one and this one votes me, but if we go there, am I still sure that I will remain with those votes? Those are the questions. So these are the things that probably could hinder these people from settling there. So as you plan the resettlement and relocation, you also need to have answers for this question if you want to have a very successful kind of program. Then will government temporarily relocate us to nearby places so that we can continue using our fertile soils for agriculture?